Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Doctor.
Good afternoon, Doctor.
Yeah. 14th. We'll start. By the way, the 10th, by the way, Tapi semua, I did not, some of you still not, some of the students still not here. Right? Test will be, I'm proposing the test that right? Instead of 2 p.m., I'm proposing to get it, to do it at 8:30 p.m. Is it okay for you? Sebab itu bulan puasa, kan? Right?
Is that
so is it okay? 8:30 p.m.? We'll discuss again.
9.
Before, you want to have 9 p.m., is it? But I think someone mentioned 9. I think one of you mentioned 9, kan, tadi?
9, Doctor. 9 p.m.
Okay. Boleh. 9, ya. Then we reconfirm again toward end of the class. Apalah saya. Okay, let's discuss the tutorial. A bit rush at 1 hour. So have you gone through the tutorial solutions that I share in e-learning? So do you want me to discuss all or is there any particular, any soalan yang tutorial that you want me to focus? Discuss, oh, 1 hour, no, Chris. 1 hour, impossible, discuss, oh. Really? Okay, see how lah. We stop at tutorial, I yet to share the slide. Right? Chris is bullying me, no? Chris bullying me by wanting to discuss, oh. 1 hour, Chris. That's the purpose. The whole purpose I want you all to go through first. Right? Mm. Okay. We have discussed tutorial 3, right? Am I right? Let me take a look for. Okay, now we'll discuss quickly number 4. Number 4. Okay, this is talking about. Okay. So, the first thing that, as per usual, that I will ask is how many decision variables for this tutorial? Or what are the decision variables? Before we talk about how many, okay, maybe the first question, what are the decision variables? What are the decision variables?
Number of focus.
Apa dia Anissa sekali lagi?
Number of additional labor hours worker.
Number of additional. Dia tak ada je. Hours of contracted worker. So okay. You see, normally my question is what are the decision variables? Normally the answer will appear either in the starting of the tutorial or the end of the tutorial. For this case, decision variable there, the decision variables, you can refer to here, the company must choose how many hours that should contract with each worker. Okay, this is something that the company need to decide. Right, the company need to decide this. How many hours that's contracted to each worker. So the next thing is, so by now you know that the decision variable is how many hours that's contracted to the worker. So the next thing is, how many worker?
Three.
Three. Worker 1, worker 2, and worker 3. Therefore, there will be three what? Three decision?
Variable.
Variable, correct. So the first decision variable will be the number of hour that contracted to worker one, the number of hour that contracted to worker two, but to make it more, to make it perfect, it's good to add, it's good to add per week. The answer scheme can be accepted lah, tetapi to make it perfect, I think it's good to put per week untuk semua. Per week, per week. Because every single unit is by weeks. Okay, done, decision variable. So how many constraint that, rubber constraint? How many constraint? Okay. Sorry? Sorry, five, berapa?
Ten, doctor.
Ten?
Five.
Okay, example, if we do know how many constraints, then you just, because you already know there are three decision driver, what you can do is you write down the decision driver first. Assume that you do know the constraint. Assume that you do know this. Assume that you do know this. Then you start reading. Then you start reading the tutorial. And then you try to fill in the, assume that you do know this first. You do know. You start reading. Okay. Subcontract worker will be on work a maximum of 20 hours. Okay, this sentence telling us that this is the first constraint whereby the maximum hour that this company will go for subcontracting work is 20 hours. Okay. Then what are you going to put here? Then I'll do it later. Then the second sentence. The company must produce at least 200 units of product A, 300 units of product B, and 400 units of product C. And then from there, you know, okay, there's another three constraints. Product A, product B, product C. Okay. If you're not able to solve, identify the number of constraints, so you can do it this way, one by one. Then product A is how many? 200, is it? And then 300, 400. Okay, so you've done. It's very bad. It's okay, never mind. Yeah. In 1 hour of work, worker one can produce 15 units of product A. So worker one can produce 15 units of product A here. 10 units of product B. Adjust this, I couldn't write properly. And C, 30, is it? So get it a habit, cancel the number they have transferred to the columns. Then 5A, 20B for worker 2. 5A, 20 and 5. Done. And then worker C is 20, 15, 25, okay. All right. So this, what are the sign that I should put here? I write very, very bad. Yeah. 200, 20, 200, 300, 400. The first one is 20 hour. 200, is it? Okay. What? Should I put smaller and equal or greater than and equal? At least. Okay, here. Okay. So I forgot to ask, what is the objective for this tutorial? I purposely, this topic basically is discussing maximization. I purposely put another minimization question here. Minimization. And then what would be the next? I've done this. If a dentist can produce 20 All right, so worker one demand a salary. So labor cost is reflected by salary. Worker one 50. Agent is unpopular. And then worker two, 40 hours. Then worker three. Okay. So nearly there, but there are three blank here. So what should I put here?
I've done everything.
Sorry?
One.
It's because they got that, because here indicated that subcontract worker will be only work at maximum 20 hours a week. Means this company is only allowed 20 hours for subcontracting work. So the total numbers that are allocated for worker 1, worker 2, and worker 3, the total number must be smaller or greater? Smaller. So done. So I don't expect you want me to discard it. This one is quite straightforward. So you get this answer here. Okay. Ada soalan? Anything you want to ask for tutorial for? Tak ada? Nothing eh? Okay. Tutorial 5. Oh, tutorial 5 very tricky. How many decision driver for tutorial 5? How many?
Oh.
For Y4? I thought only two. Why four? Consider a product mix where the decision involves determining the optimum production level of X and Y. When I ask this question, normally students will say, two. Because this sentence, production level of product X and Y. These are the two common decision drivers. What are the other two? What are the other two? If you say four, what are the other two?
Of additional hour.
Okay, maybe it's good. Some of you maybe can understand the scenario. Some of you maybe would not sort of like have a clear picture of what this tutorial means. I try to explain to you. This company is producing two product X and Y. Okay, and this product X and Y need to go through two departments or two steps of the process. The first step process is go to department one. And the second process is go to is done by department two. Department two. Okay. So in this company, the worker or the labels that everyone in this company, department one and department two are doing different process. Department one, department two do different process. So therefore, the worker in department one need to have a special skill or knowledge. And worker in department two also need to have a special skill of and knowledge on how to carry out the process. And in this company, the labor or the worker in this company can split into three groups. The labor in this company can split into three groups. The first group, have skill to do job in department one. Okay. So the second group are operator or worker that have skill to do jobs or processes in department two. As I told you, these two departments require special skill and knowledge. So this group of people have skill to carry out job in department one. This group of people have skill only to carry out job in department two. On top of that, there's another group of operator or worker that can do both. Can do both process a job in department one and two. Faham? Faham, right? No? Yes? No? Okay, that is what it means. It means, you see, currently 1,000 hour labor time at Ribbon Department 1 means this group of people that only have skill that can do process in Department 1. Arrival time is 1,000 hours. And this group of people, the second group of people, the time they arrive, that they can contribute for Department 2 is 1,200 hours. And this group of people, the third group of people, is 400. Okay. So this company is producing X and Y. Yeah? So X and Y basically is the first two rival, your two rivals. Okay. However, we do know the time arrival for a group of people is 400, but we do know how many hours should go to Department 1, how many hours should go for Department 2. For example, you have 400 workers. You don't know how many workers you want to give to Department 1. You don't know how many workers you want to give to Department 2. So this is another two decision driver that we don't know. That we need to make. Decision driver that we need to make. Faham? Therefore, there are four decision driver. Is it clear? This explanation? Yeah. So there are four decision variables. The first two variables related to the production quantity. The production quantity of X, production quantity of Y. So this group of people, we call it multi-skill, or they call it cross-train. And then the third and fourth variable are the times that allocated to Department 1. And the fourth variable is the time that allocated to Department 2. For this third group of people. Therefore, you have four variables here. So the first two variables is product related quantity of product for X and Y. Then three and four is the additional hour. Why we call additional hour? We call additional hour because Department 1 originally there is 1,000 hour the arrival. And Department 2, there's another 1,200 hours that arrive for Department 2. So this additional labor that assigned to Department 1 and 2, we call it additional. These are the additional hours. So faham tak? Is it clear that what I explained so far? Clear. So how many constraints? If clear, then how many constraints? How many constraints? If you don't know, no problem. Make the table first. We just assume that because from the previous slides, we confirmed that there are four variables. Then you just write down the four variables, product X, product Y, additional hour for Department 1, additional hour for Department 2. You can leave this blank first. Then you start reading the tutorial or the solar or the questions. Okay, you start reading. So what is the objective? The objective basically is to maximize the profit. Alright. So we start reading optimum production level 2. Okay, this one done. A unit of X require 4 hours of labor in Department 1 and 6 hours labor in Department 2. Now we know already. There are two constraints from this sentence. The first constraint is Department 1, the second constraint is Department 2, or labor in Department 1, labor in Department 2. So product X requires 4 hours in Department 1 and 6 hours in Department 2. Done. For these two. A unit of Y requires 3 hours labor in Department 1. In 8 hours in Department 2. Done. These two. Then, currently 1,000 hour labor arrival in Department 1. As I explained earlier, there are 1,000 workers, mean there are 1,000 hours, sorry. Their group of workers that train to operate the department one. And with my pen. Yeah, with my pen, I couldn't find. Okay. There's 1,200 at department two. There's furthermore 400 additional hours. Okay. So we know there's another constraint additional hour. 400. Okay. That's split to both departments. Okay. Then 400 done. There's profit for X is 50. Profits for Y is 60. Apparently, I have transferred all the number into the table, but there's still so many blank there. Okay, start with the additional hour. Additional hour, what should I put here? What should I put here? What is this additional hour? The 400 need to split into department 1 and department 2. Means the total hour that allocated for department 1 and department 2 must not more than 400. Am I right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So what should I put here? Where should I put? Does the additional hour anything related to X1, X2? No. So this one? One. Then means the total hour, the additional hour given to department one and plus the additional hour given to department two must. Must what? Smaller, greater? Smaller or equal to 400. Huh? So what happened? Because the third group of multi-skill or cross-trained worker only can contribute 400. So the hour that is split to department one and two must be less than 400 hours. Okay. Now, if I ask you now, example, don't look at these two first. If I ask you, how in total hour arrival in departments one, example. So how many, what's the total hour that arrival in department one? At this moment, department one arrival 1,000, right? Am I right? Betul, okay, take a look. Department one's the other 1,000. The total number is 1,000 plus this one. Betul tak? Sebab, because the third group of operator, the multi-skill operator, will also be allocated to department one. And this is our X3. And this is our X4. So the total hour in department one will be 1,000 plus X3. The total number in department one will be 1,000 plus X3. The total number in department two will be 1,200 plus X4. Agree? Yeah? Okay, if agree, you see, if I put this number here, this is, why green color? I couldn't find my pointer. Okay. Plus 1x3. X3 means plus 1x3. This is plus 1x4. Am I right? Right. So now I want to move. I want to move this 1x3 and 1x4 to here. Therefore, when I move x3 to here, here become negative 1, here nothing, here negative 1, here nothing, and there's no more. Paham? Understand?
Why negative?
Okay, good. Negative. Okay. Then
Let me. Pen saya dekat mana? Tak jumpa. Oh, okay. Erase this one first. Erase this one. Easy for me to write. Okay, erase this also lah. Okay. Okay. Until here, you understand? Why erase the zero there? Until here, understand, huh? Then if I plus this one, do you understand if I say plus? This one agree? So understand, huh? Somebody feeling understand, huh? Okay. Okay, now I change a little bit. So what is the symbol that I need to put here? Greater or smaller? Smaller, okay. Sampai sini faham, ah? Okay, now I take the first one first. I take the first one. The first one is... four x1 plus 3 x2 smaller than 1,000 plus x3. Okay? But in order for me to key in my linear programming into QN window, I need to move x3 to the left-hand side, for right-hand side to left-hand side. So therefore, here become 4x1 plus 3x2 minus. Why minus? Because I'm moving from right side, right-hand side to left-hand side, plus become minus, right? Am I right? So, 1,000. That's the reason here become negative. Understand, eh? Understand, eh? Okay. Okay, then here. If we do want to use, if we, for the sake of developing linear programming, but not for the purpose of QN window, you can stop here. But when you stop here, you're not able to key in to QN window. You might not understand why it says so, but when it comes to week 5, you know, oh, all right. In order to key in to QN window, you have to do it in this way. Okay, yeah? All right, done. So if that is the case, then subsequently, you can convert into the linear programming lah, as I written earlier on. Lah. So this would be, what is that? Smaller. Ada soalan? Anything that you in doubt for tutorial number 5? Tak ada. Tak ada, eh? Okay. Alright, kalau tak ada, then we done tutorial for chapter 1. Right? Then chapter 2A. Tutorial for chapter 3A, how many there are 2? Which of the tutorial you want to discuss? The 12:30, no? Which tutorial you want to discuss? You want to discuss both, or you discuss 1? Oh, Chris, which one do you discuss? Do you discuss all? Very quickly. This one, Yanni, you want me to discuss this one? Tak ada jawapan. This one. Okay, this one quickly lah, because nobody answered me, I worry that. Okay, this story basically is saying that this company is producing a pack of pet biscuits. Means that you got one package, and in the package there are 2 types of biscuits. One is chicken flavor, is it? Yes. One is chicken flavor. The biscuit, that chicken flavor, and then their biscuit of liver flavor. So what the company want to do? The company want to minimize the cost of this pack of pet biscuits. Okay. Therefore, what is the decision driver? What is the decision driver? biscuit, correct. So how many type of biscuit? Two type. Therefore, the decision variable is X one number liver correct biscuit in a pack. So the company want to decide how many biscuits with chicken and liver flavored in a pack. Rubber biscuit for chicken, rubber biscuit for liver. In order to fulfill the nutrients requirements. Okay, so this is the decision variable. So how many nutrients that discuss here? A and B, is it? So there are two nutrients, means at least there are two constraints. Besides that, any more constraints? The next one, the company have decided that cannot be more than 15. Company policy, right? So this one constraint, second constraint, the third constraint here. Third constraint, this is a policy constraint. The mining company saying that in one package cannot be more than 15 liver biscuit. Okay. So by saying so, we can start put on the table. This is the table. This is the table. Okay, and then we start. I think I'm not going to read this one. This one I think should be okay. Can I just click and show the answer? Why I cannot click the one? Okay. All right, so basically this is the one you can get from the tutorial. Okay. So this is quite straightforward, I think. You just read it, then you'll get this. You'll get this. Then subsequently, there's one more yang kita belum, we didn't discuss it here. The company had decided cannot be more than 15 flavors of packaging. Liver is X2. Mean? X2 cannot be. X2 must be. Yeah. So this is the one. Don't tell. So about some unit sama. What size that you need to put here? Greater or smaller? Oh no. At least there's greater. At least it's greater. Okay. So you'll get this one. Okay, you'll get this one. Ada soalan nak untuk ini? No. Okay, what is the second one? Oh, Yeni. Oh, this is most of the questions that, okay, sabar pun. Tadi ada lima soalan in the previous chapter. Out of the five, I think two or three are final exam questions, the past year question. And these two, question one, I can't remember. But tutorial two, definitely, this is a final exam question. This was the final exam questions a couple of years back. And this question was for me. I'm the one that prepared this question. But I noticed that there's one thing mistake here. Never mind. I can't remember where. Never mind. Later, when we come there, we'll know. Okay. Why is my question? Because Pengerang. Pengerang, my hometown. Anyone from Pengerang here? Ada siapa dari Pengerang?
Dekat je dengan
Pengerang. Mana banyak nama. I tahu lah. Okay. Siapa Pengerang dapat makan bonus 5 makan? Tak ada. Ada siapa nak pretend orang Pengerang? Chris. Chris jangan tipu. I know where you're from. Alright. How many decision variable for this? I tahu berapa? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5?
4.
4. Oh, okay lah. 4 tu dah dekat lah. Okay lah. So, berapa decision variable? How many decision variable? This tutorial 2. Oh, why 4? Because? 2. Yeah, correct. So, in both of the product, there are two products. Super 2 and Green Grow. What the company want to know is, the company want to know here, would like to The company would like to know the number, mean the amount of the each brand of fertilizer produced at each plant. Therefore, there are four variables. Variable 1, variable 2, 3 and 4. Upper variable there, the variable are, number 1, the quantity of Super 2 produced at Pasir Gudang plant. The quantity of Super 2 produced at Pengerang plant. The quantity of green grow produced at Pasir Gudang and Pengerang. Lah. So there are four. There are four decision variables. Lah. Okay, there are four. Next, what is the objective function or what is the objective for this company? What is the objective?
Maximize.
Yes, maximize the profit. Where is the profit? Where is the profit? Is this a profit? This is a car. So where is the profit?
Yeah.
This is a car. So you see, this is the... This table showing the cost. Profit is equal to selling price minus cost, right? So you must find the selling price. Where is the selling price? Yeah. Selling price here. For Super 2, the selling price is 9 ringgit per kg. For Green Grow, the selling price is 7. Therefore, if I want to work out the profit, the selling price for Super 2 is 9. The selling price for Green Grow, 7. Right? 7. So if I want to find out the profit here must be 9 minus 2, so equal to 7. Here must be 9 minus 5, minus 4 equal to 5. Here must be 7 minus 2 equal to 5. Here must be 7 minus 3 equal to 4. So I still remember when this question was asked a couple of semesters back, many of students make a mistake. The objective function, the student take this number directly and put into objective function. No, this is not the objective. This is not the profit. These are all the cost. Okay, so objective function is this. Take from there, and as what I have done just now, 9 minus 2, so it's 7554, is it? 7554, correct? 7554. So you've done the objective function. And subsequently, go one by one to identify the constraint. Okay. We start with the first paragraph. The first paragraph, there's one constraint there called resources arrival. Resources arrival basically is capacity. Capacity. So, the plant at Pasir Gudang can produce 5,000 and the plant at Pengerang can produce 6,000. So this is the one. Capacity, yeah? Pasir Gudang capacity 5,000. Eh? And then the plant at Pengerang 6,000. What should I do there? What should I put? What number should I put? What is this 5,000? This 5,000 is the capacity at Pasir Gudang. So I only interested on Pasir Gudang. Pengerang not interested. Therefore, Pasir Gudang, Pengerang. Understand? How about the 6,000? The 6,000 kg. How about the 6,000 kg? The 6,000 kg is purely referred to capacity for Pengerang. Oh, not I tahu lah Pengerang. So Pengerang, you only interested in Pengerang and Pengerang. Pasir Gudang. None of the business. So like this. Okay. Done. So what is the sign that you put here? Capacity, mean? Less or equal. Okay, done. Slap. The first two constraints again. Slap the first two constraints. Okay. So slap the first two constraints. Now, go to the second paragraph. I can do coursework there, but because the slide, I should do coursework. It's okay, because the slide appear that the second constraint is the demand. So I'll do demand first. Okay, so demand is referring to product. Tadi yang sebelum ini, capacity refer to plant. So demand is refer to product. So therefore, what are the two products? We have two products. Product pertama nama dia, macam ada Apple lah. Super 2, then another product is Green Grow. So we have two lah. Okay, so ST, Super 2 demand, GG, Green Grow demand. So demand for Super 2 is, demand for Super 2 is berapa? 6,000 lah. KG. So this is Super 2. So I'm only interested in Super 2. Green Grow, not interested. So it's 1100. What should I put here? Demand, daily demand, maximum, so? Less than, because maximum, right? Then the second one, change color, change to penggerak. Green Grow. Oh, I miss my hometown lah. My hometown took over by this what lah, Rapid Project, right? So, kampung saya dah tak ada lah, dah hilang. This 7,000, that's why I remember there's a mistake. This is be KG. KG, eh? 7,000 KG, Green Grow. So we're only interested on Green Grow. So Green Grow. 1100. Oh, dapat another two constraint. Faham, yeah? Clear, yeah? Okay, so we have this, huh? So now we look into the another constraint. We have done this. So we look at this another constraint called budget. Budget means the cost. Definitely, every company you have the budget. You cannot operate more than the budget. So this is the cost. The cost is 45,000. RM. What should I put here?
The cost,
exactly, better. Exactly, great, is here. The cost are given in the summary table earlier. Right? So to produce a Super 2 at Pasir Gudang is RM2. To produce a Super Grow at Penggerang is RM4. To produce a Green Grow at Pasir Gudang is RM2. At Penggerang is RM3. What symbol should I put here? Budget cost, please. Yes, I cannot go beyond the budget. Okay, so you sorted another constraint. Now go to another constraint. Oh, so many constraints. This constraint saying that strategy. What does it mean? It means very common to the company operation. You must have the minimum operation quantity. If you don't produce over this quantity, maybe this quantity reflects the break-even point. If Penggerang and Pasir Gudang factory produce 4,000 kg above, then they start making profit, and maybe lah. If below, then no. So this is a policy. Capacity, is it? Oh, policy, yeah? Policy, strategy. Yeah? Strategy for both, for each plant. So there'll be another two. strategy for Pengerang, strategy for Pasir Gudang, both are the same. 4,000. Start with Pasir Gudang. So this is Pasir Gudang. I'm only interested on Pasir Gudang. Pasir Gudang. So quantity that produced at Pasir Gudang plus quantity that produced green gold in Pasir Gudang must be, what is it? Bigger, smaller? Bigger, minimum. Bigger. Okay. Chris, the lunch break, Chris. Then another one is 4,000 here. And now, because it's for Pengerang, I'm only interested on Pengerang. Pengerang. 1,100. Oh, done. Ada lagi dah yang tertinggal? Then I can convert this into the linear programming model. You see, this linear programming model make up of 4 decision drivers, quite a long objective functions, and also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 constraints. So can you check, can you solve this constraint using, can you solve this linear programming using graphical method? Cannot. There's no graph that can solve because involve 4. Definitely have to do it using QM for Windows. Okay, so ada soalan nak untuk ini? Oh, maksudnya. 12:46. This one I do like 1 hour plan. Ada soalan? Anissa, soalan? Zafira, ada soalan?
Doktor?
Yes.
Kalau constraint tu betul, tapi kalau buat table tu ada salah, tak?
Maksudnya, okay, soalan Zafira yang macam ni. Dekat sini, semua betul. Tapi sini ada silap. Is it? Okay, in the end, I only look at this. This is important. This is important. Ini kalau silap pun, sikit saja tolak makam. Okay, sikit saja. Nak kosong pun berapa? Sikit. Kosong pun 5. Pun 5 banyak juga kan? Sikit saja lah. Okay. Alright. Okay, tak ada, ada soalan tak untuk yang ini? Ini lengthy. Dia tak susah. Dia perlu... That's why my solution ini, I step by step show you how to do that. So you just follow this. Then there's another thing, saya lupa nak sebut. Sebab dia soalan dia panjang, because the question is a bit lengthy. So I don't use, I try to use the table to address regardless what type of constraint. Operation constraint, demand constraint, strategy constraint, saya pun guna table to make the life easier lah. If not, we tend to miss up certain constraint lah. Okay. Kalau tak ada, oh, this is the full answer lah. Not sure. Ini yang, oh, ini is a linear programming. This is a linear programming. Okay. Oh. Have to use QM window lah. The last. The 12:50, tapi kita belum discuss satu lagi. But this one is quite straightforward. Ini ada soalan tak? Yang ketiga ini. Ini senang kan? Kacang kan? Eh, cakap tak macam ni. Okay, but there's one, what, I think there's a few things yang sana I want to share with you all. When you come to a transportation problem, right, the first thing you need to do is, you must sort out the demands and sort out the supply. In this case, supply, I refer to this. Production, we call it production, or we call it supply. And this is demand. You must sort out first. Example, if I sort out this, ini berapa? 75, Then I thought that this.
45.
Okay, so you see this, apparently this is different from the class exercise that we discussed. Example, the class exercise that we discussed. You see, the class exercise that we discussed, the demands and the supply is the same. It's the same, Correct? But this is different. This is the demand is less than the supply, or the supply is more than the demand. In this case, what is the implication? The implication here, if the supply total quantity, the sum of the supply is equal to the sum of the demand, then at constant, kita semua pakai equal sign. If the demand is the same, if the demand and the supply end up with the same number, then you see the constraint all carry an equal sign. Okay, carry equal sign. Because it's the same, you make sure that it's equal lah. But in this case, tutorial ni tak sama kan? Different lah. So, which one demand and supply, which one you cannot use equal sign? You cannot use equal sign, which one? Constraint, there are two constraints, right? There are two big group of constraints, supply constraint and demand constraint. Supply constraint cannot use equal sign, but demand, you must use equal sign. Why? Because you must fulfill the requirement, you must fulfill. So you must use equal sign. However, here you cannot use equal sign. You cannot use, because you are producing supply that more than demand. Kalau supply more than demand, then at constraint for supply, you must use a smaller equal sign. Mengapa? Example, Detroit 25, produce 25 engine. If you put equal sign, means Detroit must deliver all the 25 out from the plant. You can't do that. If you do that, then the quantity that you send to the firm will be more than what they want. So you couldn't. You must put less or equal. Produce 25, not necessarily send 25, because the demand is less than the supply. So this is a big difference. Number two is dalam kelas punya exercise this. There are special policy constraint. Company from here. There are two, okay, there's one. No. Company from the engine that made by Charlotte is not going to accept engine that made in Charlotte. So engine that made in Charlotte cannot send to Charlotte. Okay. And then here as well. Louisville is not going to accept engine from Detroit. So these are the so-called policy, which very common happen in the supply chain. This company A said, I'm not going to get anything from this supplier. It's very common. So the rest is quite similar to the example in the class. You have to define the decision variable. But you need to mention here, one is equal to what, two is equal to what, three is equal to what, four is equal to what, Detroit, Charlotte, Seattle, or whatever. Then A equal to what, B equal to what, C equal to what. Then objective function as per usual. You might notice that this is what I mentioned. These four constraints are for the supply. Supply, right? You see, we have four supply, therefore we have four constraint, and these four constraint, you can't use the equal sign, you must use the smaller or equal, because your supply is more than demand, and these three are demand. You can do it this way, or you can, example here, you can do it this way, you can put it 1B, plus X2B plus X3B plus X4B equal to 20. Demand you must put equal because you must fulfill the demand and then do supply more, do supply more than what demanded. You can put here 1C, 2C, 3C, and tired already, 1 o'clock then. Plus X4C. The difference between what the answer scheme and what I written here is I have additional 2B here. Eh, mana saya punya pen? Kuning tak nampak lah. Alamak, change to other color. Ah, okay, here I got additional this, I got additional this. You also can write your constraint for your demand in this way. Also, sama, correct. Okay. Because we got additional constraint here. This constraint, if me, I will write it better way. I will write it like this. What are these two? This saying that there will be nothing transport from two must be two must be what? Feathered to shallots. Okay, correct. And then 4C, there will be no transport of engine from Detroit to Louisville, correct? Correct. So these two are additional policy constraints. The two sahaja lah. So at this one, we're going to solve it using simplex methods and also QN for Windows. Okay. Ada soalan untuk ini?
Doktor.
Yeah.
Kalau macam yang decision variable ni guna method yang ni kan? Kan ada lagi satu method tu kan, doktor?
Yang panjang lebar tu. Boleh tak masalah. Dia leceh sikit saja. Maksudnya let x 1a equal to apa? 1b equal to apa itu kan?
Lepas tu doktor.
Boleh. Tapi dia perlu tulis berapa variable panjang lah. Tak ada salah.
Lepas tu kan ada macam yang ada road yang tak lalu tu kan. So kalau buat yang satu tu, kena letak juga or kena buang?
Dua-dua pun boleh. Tetapi saya galakkan letak. Sebab kalau buang nanti tersalah buang.
Okay.
Kalau nak buang kan, you boleh buang. Okay, the answer is ideal lah. I know what you try to ask. Answer yang sebenar dia macam ni dah. Ada dua cara. Satu you letak. Satu you buang kan. Correct ah? Correct ah? Kalau you letak. Kalau you letak. Make sure at the end dia mesti ada yang ni. Make sure yang ni mesti ada dekat constraint. Kalau you buang. Ini ada pun okey, ini tak ada pun okey. Sebab you dah buang. Okey, tetapi based on my experience, student dia buang, kadang-kadang dia tersilap buang. So biasa saya galakkan student jangan buang dekat sini. Ini yang masa nak develop auditive function, masa nak develop constraint itu, ikut langkah yang biasa saja, jangan buang. Takut tersilap buang. Then, in the end, lepas dah siap semua, tambah dua ini. Selamat. You get me?
Okay.
Kalau tak ada, then we still, tadi when we started our class, I proposed to have our test at, okay, we had discussed earlier lah, at the beginning of the class. So the proposal is we're going to have a test one on the 18th of April 2021, which is Sunday, 9 p.m. The test will be 1 hour. Anyone tak boleh mazhab be no now. don't later at the end of the day, before 18, 1 or 2 days, send me a message. Eh? Because I combine this test with section 1. I want everyone to make it. So any problem? Last call. Tak ada, eh? Until the graphical method. I will share more detail. I can share it now. Lah. Dua soalan lah. Soalan pertama basically is I give you a scenario that you develop a linear programming. Oh, you develop linear programming. And then soalan kedua, a linear programming given to you. Then you solve the linear programming using graphical method. And these two soalan are two different soalan. No? Doesn't mean that you're going to solve you're going to solve the soalan for the graphical method for soalan satu. Dua-dua itu soalan yang berbeza lah. Soalan pertama, satu scenario. Lepas itu, you develop linear programming untuk soalan pertama. Dah. Hanya develop the linear programming. Then subsequently, soalan dua, linear programming given to you. You solve by using graphical method. By saying so, you need to prepare a graph paper lah. Difficult level lah. Soalan itu saya prepare sebelum semester start lah. What? No, semester dah started sebab saya last minute ask to teach you soalan. I think the first week I prepared this soalan. So bila saya ambil, when I look back the soalan few days back, I think yesterday or day before yesterday, I look at the soalan again. My first thought is very easy, too easy. So maybe I'm going to make it more difficult, depend. I still have time to change. Straightforward lah. Why so easy? Okay, see how lah. Okay, maybe test one give chance lah. Depend. So no problem on this. If no problem, then we still going to meet next week, right? So it's got 1 week to discuss. We still yet to discuss the what after this? What appear the screen now? We still yet to discuss the tutorial. What appear on the screen now, Chris? Ayo. I forgot to share it. How about now? Kadiran, so yeah, section 2. I must find a way. I do not cast 1 hour number one, number two. I do not cast at 12 PM. We must find a way to resolve, see how. But we're not going to have a class every Thursday, it depends. Oh, ini ialah masa yang setiap student paling aktif sekali. Scanning, oh. Yang activity line semua tak aktif. Scan saja, oh, semua jadi begitu aktif sekali. Oh, begitu cepat. Oh, cepat, tepat. Cekap semua. Oh. Alright, so okay lah. See you next week, Wednesday. We're going to look into another topic, sensitivity. Then we're also going to discuss a tutorial for graphical method. Huh? Alright, that's it. Okay. Thank you very much, everyone. See you.
Thank you, Doctor.
Welcome. Bye.
Thank you, Doctor.
Eh, tadi kita nak record lah. Tak ada orang yang ingatkan saya nak record. Tak apa, takkan cari sorry dengan saya. Saya tak rugi apa-apa, yang rugi orang saja. Well, it's okay lah. Tutorial will be okay. Okay.